Hello, I'm Iulia Mihaiu. I'm a master's student in cybersecurity at Transylvania University of Brasov from Romania. The project I was working on is visualization and analysis of cross-chain transaction, and I was working together with Rafael Belchior and Sabrina Scuri. With this project, we aim to create a framework to assess the performance of a blockchain interoperability solution, and also to advance the process of making the interoperability more user-friendly to both experts and non-experts users. Analyzing and visualizing cross-chain transactions can help stakeholders understand bottlenecks, identify processes, discover security issues, and even provide more control over a blockchain interoperability solution. The two main research questions we explored were how to visualize cross-chain rules and what are the relevant metrics to assess cross-chain transactions and solutions. During the development of this project, I was working with Hyperledger Cactus, Fabric and Vesu, and also using TypeScript and Node.js. The main objective was understanding, the first objective was understanding the architecture of Hyperledger Cactus, which quite took some time because it was quite complex. The second objective was conducting a user study in order to develop a better understanding of what metrics and pieces of information are the most relevant for end users when performing blockchain transactions, and gather some insight on how to visualize these transactions effectively. The third objective was implementing the solution, the actual plugin, and the last objective was writing the technical report. On the project deliverables, the first deliverable was the user study plan, and then the user survey that I disseminated. The second deliverable was the code for the new plugin, and the last deliverable was the technical report. To better explore the research questions mentioned before, we put forward some preliminary research where we surveyed experts in blockchain interoperability, so people using and developing blockchain interoperability solutions, and also non-experts, people using and developing blockchain-based solutions. A total of 26 individuals participated in the survey. Most of them were software developers and blockchain architects. Among them, five are experts. Most of the respondents in our sample are very experienced, with only five people having less than 1 year of blockchain experience. Since research on the semantic level of blockchain interoperability is still maturing, to the best of our knowledge, there is no system in production to help users track cross-chain logic or gather and view cross-chain transaction metrics. So we asked the respondents to rank the importance of specific criteria or metrics using a Likert scale from 1 to 5 based on the relevance of their work on the blockchain solutions. And the performance metrics such as end-to-end latency and throughput, and also the cost, are the primary concerns for cross-chain analysis. Next, I will show a use case that was also used in our survey to help people understand the cross-chain transaction concept. So to start off with, a cross-chain transaction is a set of local blockchain transactions such that all are executed or none is. Also, cross-chain rules or cross-chain logic are a mapping between input from a set of ledgers to trigger behavior on a set of ledgers. Therefore, the cross-chain logic can trigger cross-chain transactions, which translate into local transactions. In the use case that I have here, we have a permission network, Hyperledger Fabric, gathering the energy used and converting it to emissions. Then these emissions are tokenized as emission tokens on the public Ethereum network so that you could trade emissions against allowances or offsets or pay for emissions reductions. So practically, when rule one is triggered, Cactus creates the first transaction, the converting the energy into emissions, which is directed to Fabric. And when the second rule is triggered, Cactus creates the second transactions, tokenizing the emissions, which is directed to Ethereum. Next, we have the architecture of our plugin. So practically, we extended the Fabric and Besu connectors to send the transaction receipts to our plugin through RabbitMQ, which is an open source message broker based on a subscriber publisher pattern. So in our plugin, we get the receipts and we transform them into cross-chain events, which look like this. We have a timestamp, a blockchain ID, which is the ledger type, the invocation type, which is the smart contract function, parameters, which are the smart contract parameters. And also we have the most important thing, the case ID, which helps us identify the transactions that are part of the same cross-chain transactions. And at the moment is provided by the user. All of those cross-chain events will then be collected in a cross-chain event log. And all those entries from the log will be then analyzed and run through a process mining algorithm to have the final mapping of the transaction. So we can know the order and the causality of the transactions, having an idea of how to visualize them. All of these and also the metrics will be sent to the front end. This last part is not ready yet, but it will soon be. As most challenging, I think keeping up with the Hyperledger Cactus main branch and also the merging, at least at the beginning, finding a proper way to visualize the cross-chain logging because there are no references. So you practically didn't have a model to go to. And what was challenging also was getting as many responses as possible to the survey, because conducting a user study in summer, it's a bit harder just because people are harder to reach because they are on vacation. Recommendations for future work, formalizing the cross-chain logic and cross-chain state concepts, and also working towards creating an interface that allows us to visualize the most important metrics according to the respondents. End-to-end latency and throughput, total transaction fees, and visualization of cross-chain transaction rules. The code can be found here at this link, and the technical report will be finished soon. It's almost done, and it will be published. Some insights gained. I learned how to build a plugin and write code with better readability. I learned about the process of open source project development, and also a main thing is in research, you need to have a lot of patience. A lot of iterations are needed to get something right. And when you think that something is right, you still need some more iterations to it. And as advice, I would say take your time to learn and understand the things, keep up with the main branch and ask more specific questions and as many as possible before starting implementing the stuff. At the end, I would want to say a big thank you to my mentors, Rafael and Sabrina, who helped a lot, and also to the members of the community. Thank you.
Thank you, Lunia. I it's so interesting, right, for me to see a lot of these mentorship projects are done in kind of using some of your research skills, doing surveys. I know it's challenging to get people to respond to your survey, but it, definitely sounds like you gained some, insights into the problem that you're trying to investigate. So I do see your mentor, Rafael, is here. Rafael, do you have anything to add or comment?
Oi. Can you hear me?
Yes.
No, I mean, thanks. Yeah, I would like to say that, first I would like to thank Hyperledger and you personally, Min, for setting this up and supporting throughout the different phases of the internship program.
Sure.
I think these initiatives are great because we take people from outside the community and they can add a new vision to the problems we're trying to solve within Hyperledger and also from our academic perspectives. And Julia also brought that vision from her background in cybersecurity, making us think a bit more about that. So this project was actually more directed to research. So we tried to tackle some problems that are starting to appear now. And that I think made the internship more challenging. So Julia was not only able to learn a bit of Fabric, learn a bit of Bezu, but also learn a bit of Cactus, which is a lot of different systems, right? So the I would say that the final balance is quite good because we have a very solid basis of work, which could be extended next year. So yeah, thanks for all the effort you did.
Yeah, I agree. I think the mentorship program really provides a safe space, right, for a lot of people outside the Hyperledger community to come in and investigate and contribute. And thank you for all the mentors who supported the new developers, new contributors in this learning process. I really appreciate all of your contributions.